Welcome to the Go Ham Show. I'm DJ Go Ham, and tonight we are gonna watch Kid Buu. Now, you guys already know, I like Kid Buu. He's one of my favorite rappers, but not really because he's dope at rapping, but because I like his image. Now, some of the beats that he's rapped on, though, like his opening beat for Worldstar. It was for a Worldstar video. She thought my cool was a ghost. Told that bitch no dish away. But yeah, his beats are so freaking hard, and I always just gotta give Kid Buu the credit that he can find, like, good music to write his music over. So, tonight we're just gonna watch a video that he uploaded about 5 days ago. I wanted to do it, like, yesterday. I woke up, my charger was broke, so I had to spend $80 for a Mac charger at Best Buy. It's ridiculous how much these things cost. Anyway, let's watch this video. All right, well, from the imagery, it looks like he's in a foreign location. I'm gonna assume that he's in China. So we're gonna do a little bit of a Chinese finger trap. And by Chinese finger trap, I mean hit this, because it's in my fingers and it's been trapped here ever since the last video I did.
Oh God, that did not work the way I thought it would. Anyway, let's get watching Kid Buu.
It sounds like some EDM, and I love EDM. I don't even know what the fuck he said, but I'm already fucking with the track. You wanna know why? Because I heard the word Pikachu. I hope Kid Buu at least watches anime. I really hope that he watches anime, because Takeshi 6ix9ine, that motherfucker don't watch no fucking anime. Alright, Zillikami or whatever the fuck his name is from fucking City Morgue, he came out and revealed all the Takeshi shit and said that he came up with the persona and that he doesn't even watch anime. Never in his life. And it's some bullshit. Now, Kid Buu, he better have at least known the original characters from Dragon Ball Z and know that that is who his name is based off of, because that would be really embarrassing if somebody came up to him and he didn't even know that shit. I think it's kind of cool too that he actually knows how to break dance. That's like actually kind of, that's something that you gotta get a dude. At least he's talented in many different ways. He can sing, he can dance, and by dance I mean he can actually do this. This isn't like easy motherfucking, what is that called? It's not flaring. I don't know b-boy terms. Let's go. Oh wow, it's one of these. It's a skit in the middle of the video. This is in an English country. I wonder if he's like across the pond. Anyway.
He was a famous artist in the 60s.
Yeah, that's how you know.
She's talking facts.
Unless he's giving you some do-re-mi to get you.
I don't even know the context of this video or this part, but you know what? I'm gonna make up my own context. Him and his cameraman and whoever was out there that was shooting, and they needed to get a shot from inside like one of the cathedral like little places. So they found this old couple and they actually owned it and they allowed them in, and now this is like their little shout out spot at the end of the video, and that's where they talking and they say, yo, we'll throw you into our video, and that's how they ended up in this. Is that the real reason why? I don't know, but that's what I would assume, because that's what happened to me before when I was shooting a video, and that's how I would actually implement these nice people into my videos, and that's probably what he's doing.
You know what? He has to be paying.
Got
me.
A problem? I put money on it, baby.
Yeah. Well, he's got a problem. He got a problem. It's me. And he got put money on me.
Either that or this guy's his manager and he confused Kid Buu with this nice little old lady because she got pink hair. All that just to learn where the Korean barbecue spot is. I bet you hanging out with Kid Buu is probably like... like motherfucking hangover like every day. Like shit, you'd just be chilling with this dude and he just disappear. And out of that, you finding him like in weird spots the next day, trying to retrace your steps of where he like what he did with your phone or something. And then he just takes you through all of this bullshit, all these people that you guys met, and you're just like, dog, why is any of these people even involved? Because I wasn't that fucked up, I would have remembered all this bullshit. But man, knowing Kid Buu, I don't know. I only can just know that his life could be an adventure if he wanted it to be. Now take that back. Fuck the hangover. It'd be like going to Harold. It'd be like Harold and Kumar go to Wendy's or something like that. Yeah, that's what it'd be like hanging out with Kid Buu. Well, he's talking about lean. Everybody knows what that means. Gotta take a drink. And by drink, I mean to take a drink of water. On the side like Melina chicken soup. She know that I'm a star like the ones that's on my roof. Got money like a juice. Only when he got some juice. The way that I came up, got him shot like Pikachu. I got him shot like Pikachu. Okay, that's cool. Even though he really is just doing the auto-tune mumble rapping, but I fuck with it. You know what? I gotta stop, like, addressing rappers like mumble rappers. It's just that when I can't understand anything that you say and your auto-tune begins to, like, just create sounds that just sound like music, but it doesn't make any sense, then that's why everybody start calling you mumble rappers. Yeah, he even throws in little memes and shit. You see little Pikachu right there, but yeah. I had to do this video because, man, I was like, all like, man, when's the next time you're gonna make another video, man? I need to make it as soon as he drop it, but it's been a week, so. I fuck with this track, though, because it sounds like an EDM track on some real shit. I fuck with it, Kid Buu. I'm high, though. Get out of here.